Named after the Roman god of sea, Neptune is the only planet in the solar system that was discovered by mathematical prediction rather than empirical observation. The planet also shares similar surface gravity as that of the Earth, but unlike our planet, Neptune is made of gas and ice with some rocky core. So there is no way you can actually stand on the surface of Neptune without sinking in. Not many people know about Neptune in detail because this is one of the most distant planets from our sun, and very few exploratory missions have ever ventured that far into our solar system. Most of what we know about Neptune today, including its rotation period, the existence and characteristics of its magnetic field, along with the magnetosphere, we owe to the groundbreaking discoveries from the Voyager 2 spacecraft. So, what do we know about this gas giant? Well, stick to the end of the video to learn more about Neptune's top 10 images and new discoveries. 10. Neptune has rings. Neptune would be the last planet that you would think of when we talk about rings, but it looks like even Neptune has rings, at least according to this wide-angle Voyager 2 image that was taken through the camera's clear filter. This was the very first image to show what Neptune's rings look like in detail. We have discovered two main rings, which are about 53,000 kilometers, or 33,000 miles, and 63,000 kilometers, or 39,000 miles, from Neptune respectively. These images are 5 to 10 times brighter than the earlier ones, all thanks to the difference in lighting and viewing geometry. 9. The blue Neptune everyone knows. When we talk about Neptune, the very first image that would come to your mind would be this one. This picture of Neptune was produced from the last whole planet images taken through the green and orange filters on the Voyager 2 narrow angle camera. These images were taken at least 4.4 million miles away from the planet just 4 days and 20 hours before the closest approach. This picture clearly shows the dark spot and its companion, the bright smudge. On the west limb, the fast-moving bright feature called Scooter and the little dark spots are visible. These clouds were persistent for as long as Voyager's cameras could resolve them. We can also see a bright cloud band similar to the South Pole streak in the north. 8. Breathtaking image of the crescents of Triton and Neptune. This particular image might look like it's CGI from a video game or even a movie, but that is not the case, because this dramatic view of the crescents of Neptune and Triton was captured by Voyager 2 approximately 3 days, 6.5 hours after its closest approach to Neptune. This image was captured when the Voyager was plunging southward at an angle of 48 degrees to the plane of the ecliptic. This direction, combined with the season of southern summer in the Neptune system, is responsible for the unique geometry that you find in this picture. The spacecraft was at least 4.85 million kilometers, which is about 3 million miles away from Neptune when these images were captured. You might be wondering why Neptune is not looking blue in this image. This is because the forward scattering nature of the planet's atmosphere is more important than its absorption of red light at this high phase angle, which is 134 degrees. 7. Hubble Space Telescope image. NASA recently shared another image of Neptune, and this time it was captured by the Hubble Space Telescope. This is by far the latest picture we have of the planet. We can see a monstrous dark storm near the top center that's wider than the Atlantic Ocean, along with a smaller dark spot that emerged nearby in the top right. This giant storm was previously seen moving southwards, where storms are expected to vanish due to the atmospheric forces near the equator, but it looks like it made a sudden U-turn and drifted back northward. 6. Neptune and its largest moon. Neptune has at least 14 moons, and Triton happens to be the largest natural satellite of the planet. This is also the very first Neptunian moon to be discovered way back in 1846 by English astronomer William Lassell. Triton is special because it is the only large moon in the solar system with a retrograde orbit, and orbit in the direction opposite to its planet's rotation. This particular computer-generated image shows how Neptune would appear if a spacecraft was approaching Neptune from its largest moon, which is about 2,706 kilometers in diameter. The wind and sublimination eroded the south polar cap of the Triton, and that is shown at the bottom of Triton's image. You also get to see a cryovolcanic terrain at the upper right and an enigmatic cantaloupe terrain at the upper left. Triton's surface is mostly covered by nitrogen frost mixed with traces of condensed methane, carbon dioxide, and carbon monoxide. Triton's atmosphere is only about 0.01% of Earth's atmospheric density at the surface, but it is still thick enough to produce wind-deposited streaks of dark and bright materials of unknown composition in the South Polar Cap region. The southern polar cap was sublimating during the time when Voyager 2 visited Neptune. The polar frosts were sublimating due to Triton's orbital and rotational motion caused by the sun shining directly on the polar cap for a period of several decades during Neptune's and Triton's long austral summer. 5. Neptune's ring arc. This could be one of the very first images of the rings of Neptune. This was captured by the Voyager spacecraft when it was about 8.6 million kilometers, or about 5.3 million miles away from Neptune. The Voyager cameras were programmed to make a systematic search for several faint ring arcs and new satellites. The bright upper corner of the image is slightly overexposed because of the residual image from the previous long exposure of the planet. The portion of the arc that is visible in this image is approximately 35 degrees in longitudinal extent, making it approximately 38,000 kilometers or about 24,000 miles in length. 4. Hubble's view of Neptune. This image of Neptune is arguably one of the very first images captured by the Hubble Space Telescope. These images were captured in 1994 when Neptune was about 2.8 billion miles away from Earth, or about 4.5 billion kilometers away from Earth. The Hubble telescope is the reason why so many astronomers were able to study Neptune's dynamic atmosphere with a level of detail that was not possible ever since the Voyager 2 spacecraft. Hubble's discoveries were built on the Voyager's initial discoveries. The Hubble Space Telescope was able to reveal that Neptune has a very remarkable dynamic atmosphere that changes over just a few days. The temperature difference between Neptune's strong internal heat source and its frigid cloud tops might trigger instability in the atmosphere, which results in large-scale weather changes in Neptune's atmosphere. Neptune's atmosphere is also composed of methane and hydrocarbons like ethane and acetylene, in addition to hydrogen and helium. Also, if you look closely, you will not be able to find the dark spot that you find with every other image of Neptune. And that makes this image very special, because it could be taken from a different angle, or Neptune might have completely changed since the last time the planet was photographed with a dark spot. 3. Neptune's lower cloud deck. Even though this picture looks like Neptune has got its own ocean, well, we hate to break it to you, but there are no oceans on Neptune. This picture shows some of the distinctive clouds that are hovering over Neptune's lower cloud deck. You can also see shadows cast onto the surface of Neptune by these clouds. Astronomers think that these clouds are made of methane. This image was also captured by NASA's Voyager 2 way back in 1989. The interior of the planet is made of heavy compressed gases with thick clouds covering the surface. The core might be made of rock and ice. 2. Best photos ever. The European Southern Observatory claims that this might be the best photo of Neptune so far, all thanks to the observatory's gigantic telescope. This image was snapped using a new adaptive optics mode called laser tomography. This technique is a really promising one, both in astronomy and in medical research. The technology is made possible by a multi-unit spectroscopic explorer, which works with an adaptive optics unit and can correct for the effects of atmospheric turbulence up to 1 kilometer above the telescope. Using laser tomography, the multi-unit spectroscopic explorer was able to compensate for almost all the atmospheric turbulence above the telescope to give us much sharper pictures. With this approach, astronomers were able to bypass the biggest downside of Earth-based image that was dealing with atmospheric disturbances and noise. This is also the reason why astronomers always prefer to send telescopes into space, like what we have done with the Hubble Space Telescope and also the James Webb Space Telescope. 1. View from Earth. Earlier, we might have thought that it's very difficult to capture Neptune from our planet, but this image taken by the Keck 2 telescope in Hawaii changes everything. This telescope is one of the largest telescopes in the world, and it is equipped with an adaptive optics instrument that allows the telescope to remove the blurring effect caused due to the Earth's atmosphere. To the scientific community, it looks like these are some of the best pictures we have of Neptune taken from Earth, considering the fact that this image could be the very first ground-based detection of faint rings around the gas giant. All of these new images and discoveries make Neptune a fascinating planet. We still have a lot of mysteries to uncover surrounding our distant neighbor in our solar system. We hope that sometime in the near future, more missions will be launched to explore the outer solar system so that we can dig a little deeper into the mystery surrounding these gas giants. With all the growing interest in space exploration, we think that that will happen very soon, even though we cannot predict when exactly that will be.